Okay, so let's talk a little bit about implicit differentiation involving exponential functions. And I want to do a couple examples. The first one, 6x squared plus e to the x squared y cubed is equal to 8. And you see two pieces that involve either just x or just a constant right there. And those pieces I can differentiate straightforward as we have been. So the derivative of 6x squared is 12x, and the derivative of of 8 is 0. Now this piece takes a little bit more work, so let's maybe move over here. I know that when I have e to the u, the derivative of that is e to the u times the derivative of the inside. Okay, so what I really need to find is the derivative of x squared y cubed, which involves using the product rule. So let me set up this chart. And g is y cubed, and then here where I take the derivative with something involving y, I take the derivative normally, and then I add this y prime. Okay? So you don't have to, there's no question about where to add this y prime in this piece. It's here when I actually take the derivative of something involving y. Okay? And then fg prime plus gf prime. And this is x squared times 3y squared y prime plus y cubed times 2x. So maybe 3x squared y prime plus 2xy cubed. Okay, that's just the inside. So the total derivative, that's just my du part, right? Du is finding the derivative of this inside part. So this thing is e to the u times that. So it looks like I didn't leave enough room, but right in here is where I get my e to the same thing, right? X squared y cubed, and then multiplied by out here, 3x squared y prime, 2xy cubed. Okay, so really I have 12x plus this is equal to 0. And I'm still trying to find this y prime. So come down here and let's, I mean, this is the piece again that I'm trying to find right there. So I'm going to go ahead and multiply this e piece times each of these and distribute it, and that way I can move everything over. So let's do that, 12x. And then I'll move these coefficients out front just so there's no confusing about where they go. Squared y cubed plus 2xy cubed e to the x squared y cubed is equal to 0. And again, here's my y prime piece. And so I will subtract both these other pieces, minus 12x and minus 2xy cubed e to the x squared y cubed from this side and from the other side as well. So I get 3x squared y prime e to the x squared y cubed is equal to now negative 12x minus 2xy cubed e to the x squared y cubed. And then now I just have this, and what I really am just multiplying it by this and this, so divide both sides by that and we'll be done. So I have y prime is equal to this right side. Over 3x squared, and e to the x squared y cubed. That's it. I mean, it's a mess. but that's it. Okay. Now let's do one more example, which looks like this, maybe 7y squared plus e to the 3xy is equal to 8x. Okay. And again, I have this piece involving y and this one. And 3xy will require the product rule again. So I'm going to do that piece first. So the derivative here should be e to the u du. So maybe let's write this in here. So here I have 7y. Oops, I want to take the derivative of this. So let's actually do a step. 14y times y prime. I took the derivative of something involving y. Plus e to the 3xy. And then the derivative of that, d by dx of 3xy. I have to figure out what that is. And then 8. So now, what's the derivative of 3xy? Question mark. So use the product rule. F is 3x. F prime is 3. G is y. Oops, just y. But g prime will be y prime. So fg prime plus gf prime. 3xy prime plus 3y. So I'll come back here and put that in. 4y times y prime plus e to the 3xy times 3xy prime plus 3y is equal to 8. And again, here's my y prime, and here it is again. So I still need to multiply this out, but then I'll factor out a y prime. 14y, y prime, plus 3xy prime, e to the 3xy, plus 3y, e to the 3xy, is equal to 8. Here again are my y primes, keeping track of where those are. And so this piece doesn't have any y primes. I can bring it over to the right side. Okay? So 14y y prime plus 3xy prime e to the 3xy is equal to 8 minus 3y e to the 3xy. And now I have this y prime and this y prime that I'm going to factor out. Y prime. And what's left? 14y plus 3x e to the 3xy. 8 minus 3y is e to the 3xy on the right side. And then I just divide both sides by this thing in parentheses. Right here. Okay? So I have y prime is equal to 8 minus 3y e to the 3y over 14y plus 3x e to the 3xy. Okay, let me know if you have questions.